Today, instead of talking about my research, I want to talk about symmetry. I'm talking about the symmetries we see all the time in architecture, in wallpaper, in soccer balls, tennis balls, and volleyballs. How many symmetries are there? For a ball, there are 14. There are 14 ways a ball can be symmetrical. For wallpaper, there are 17. There are 17 ways that wallpaper can be symmetrical. For a frieze, there are 7 symmetries. Now, how did I come up with these numbers? I'm going to show you a very clever, very interesting way of categorizing all the different types of symmetry. This is based on a wonderful book by John Conway, Burgiel, and Goodman-Strauss called The Symmetry of Things. Now, the book is great, but when I read it, I kept thinking this would be even better as an animation. You can do so many more things with an animation. We will describe each type of symmetry using just a few symbols. The star symbol is for reflection. We can have several reflections. The symbol star 3 means that 3 reflection lines meet at a single point. 1, 2, 3. We can also have rotational symmetry. A blue 3 means that the same pattern is rotated around a point 3 times. A volleyball has a 3-way rotation and a 2-way reflection, so its symmetry is 3 star 2. A tennis ball has a 2-way rotation and reflection, so it's 2 star 2. A soccer ball has a 5-way reflection, a 3-way reflection, and a 2-way reflection, so its symmetry is star 5 3 2. In each symmetry, you see some repeated pattern. You see some repeated shape. The same shape is repeated many times on a sphere. Now let's think about the properties that a shape on a sphere must have. A shape is made up of vertices, edges, and faces. Think of a simple triangle. It has 3 vertices, 3 edges, and 2 faces, face 1 and face 2. The number of vertices minus edges plus faces is 2. If we draw 2 triangles, we have 4 vertices, 5 edges, and 3 faces. V minus E plus F equals 2 again. This equation is always true. V minus E plus F equals 2 for any connected plane or graph. This is called the Euler map theorem. It's not hard to prove it, but I'll save that for my next video. This number, V minus E plus F, has a special name. It's called the Euler characteristic. It's 2 for spheres and planes, it's 0 for donuts, and it's negative 2 for double donuts. The Euler map theorem tells us what kinds of shapes can be copied onto a sphere. These shapes define the symmetry. Whenever you have an object with symmetry, you have some shape or some pattern that is repeated multiple times. For a basketball, we start with this pattern, and then we copy it 8 times. Now let's think about this as a graph. Think of the pattern as a collection of vertices, edges, and faces that are repeated 8 times. The technical term for this is an orbifold. Our orbifold has vertices and edges. If we copy them 8 times, we get vertices and edges that make up a sphere. Here's one vertex of the sphere. This vertex is made from 4 orbifolds, with each orbifold contributing 1/4 of the vertex. This is an edge of the sphere. This edge is made from 2 orbifolds, with each orbifold contributing half the edge. So the orbifold is made of half edges and quarter vertices. What's the Euler characteristic of the orbifold? What's V minus E plus F? This has 3 quarter vertices, 3 half edges, and 1 face. So V minus E plus F is a quarter. The characteristic is a quarter. If we copy this orbifold 8 times, the characteristic becomes 8 times a quarter equals 2, and this is the characteristic of a sphere. The idea is that we create an orbifold and compute its characteristic. Then we copy the orbifold enough times to make a characteristic of 2 to make a sphere. The basketball orbifold was copied 8 times. A soccer ball's orbifold has a characteristic of 1 over 60, so its orbifold is copied 120 times. That's 10 times 12 equals 120. Let's look at how the orbifold changes as we add symmetries to it. When we add a reflection, we see a star symbol. The star symbol means we're punching a hole in the orbifold. Around the hole, we add a reflection line. When we do the reflections appear on the opposite side of the line, filling in the hole. Creating this hole lowers the characteristic by 1, since we've removed one of the faces. Along the reflection line, we've converted edges into half edges and vertices into half vertices. But there are an equal number of both of them, so this cancels out. What happens when we add a 3-way reflection point? Now when we do the reflections, we copy the orbifold 6 times at this vertex. So each of the orbifolds contains 1/6 vertex. By adding a 3 or a reflection point, we've converted half a vertex into a 1/6 of the vertex. We've lowered the characteristic by a half minus a 1/6. In general, an n-way reflection point will lower the characteristic by half minus 1 over 2n. What happens when we add a 3-way rotation? We take the orbifold and cut it like a slice of pizza. When we apply the rotation, we copy the orbifold 3 times. This vertex came from 3 orbifolds, with each orbifold contributing a 1/3 of the vertex. By adding a 3-way rotation, we replace 1 vertex with a 1/3 of a vertex. We've lowered the characteristic by 1 minus a 1/3. In general, an n-way rotation lowers the characteristic by 1 minus 1 over n. Each time we add a symmetry, we lower the characteristic. Here's how much we lower the characteristic for each symmetry. Now we can find the orbifold's characteristic with some basic arithmetic. We start with a value of 2, that's the normal value for a planar graph, and then we start subtracting. A basketball has the symmetries star 2, 2, 2. So that's 2 minus 1 minus a quarter minus a quarter minus a quarter equals a quarter. That's what we saw before. We copy the orbifold 8 times to get a sphere. Now we can see why star 222 is a valid symmetry, but star 444 is not. Star 444 lowers the characteristic to negative an 1/8. We would need to copy it negative 16 times, which makes no sense. Star 333 is also invalid because it lowers the orbifold to 0. Now we just need to try all the different combinations and figure out when the characteristic stays positive. For a 3-sided orbifold, these reflections are allowed. Star 332, star 432, star 532, and we can also do star 22n, where n can be any number. Spheres can have 2-sided polygons, but their 2 angles must be the same. This will give us star nn for any n. In total, there are 5 symmetries that just use reflection. Now let's look at rotations. There are also 5 symmetries that just use rotation, and they have the exact same numbers. They're 332, 432, 532, 22n, and nn. There are also 4 symmetries that involve both reflection and rotation. There's 3-star 2, which volleyballs have. There's 2-star n and n-star. Finally, there's another type of reflection we can do, where we reflect the pattern and translate it, so it's not exactly a mirror reflection. The book calls this a mirrorless crossing, or a miracle, and uses the cross symbol for it. Like a normal reflection, it lowers the characteristic by 1. We've now listed the 14 possible symmetries for a sphere. Now let's look at freeze patterns. Freeze patterns repeat infinitely far in one direction. We can find the freeze patterns from the spherical patterns. Just imagine an infinitely large sphere. We can use any spherical pattern that has a parameter n and set n to infinity. There are 7 of them. Infinity, infinity, infinity cross, infinity star, star infinity, infinity, 2, 2 infinity, star 2, 2 infinity, and 2 star infinity. To find a spherical symmetry, we find an orbifold with a positive characteristic and then copy it enough times to produce a characteristic of 2. But what if we copy the orbifold an infinite number of times? If we want to create wallpaper, we need to fill in the whole plane with an infinite number of orbifolds. So the characteristic should be 2 divided by infinity, or 0. To find the symmetries for wallpaper, we are looking for orbifolds with a characteristic of 0. Again, we can just try all the different combinations, work through the math. If we look at just reflections, we get star 333, star 632, star 442, star 22222. We can also have 2 different reflections. That means star star. The numbers are the same for rotational symmetries: 3333, 632, 442, and 222222. We can also have just a translation, which the book calls a wonder. We can have both rotations and reflections, like 3 star 3, 4 star 2, 2 star 22, and 22 star. We can also replace an individual reflection with a miracle reflection to give us star cross, cross cross, and 22 cross. If you've been counting, that's 17 wallpaper symmetries. In these 17 examples, the characteristic is zero. For spherical symmetries, the characteristic is above zero. If the characteristic goes below zero, it can be used in a special kind of geometry called hyperbolic geometry. We can see it in this image. If we show the reflections, we can see here that we have a three-way reflection at each of these corners. There are four corners to the orbifold, giving us the symmetry star 3333, which has a characteristic of negative a third. That works fine in hyperbolic geometry. There are an infinite number of different hyperbolic symmetries. We've been looking at symmetries on 2D surfaces, but what about symmetries in 3D space? These balls are arranged in a symmetric 3D pattern. This pattern is actually how the atoms of a salt crystal are arranged. Here's a different symmetry. This is how the atoms of a diamond are arranged. These are called crystallographic groups, since crystals are based on them. There are the 3D equivalent of the 17 wallpaper groups. There are 219 crystallographic groups. I won't try to prove this as it gets really complicated. It only gets worse for higher dimensions. In four dimensions, there are 4,783 crystallographic groups. In five dimensions, there's over 222,000. In six dimensions, there's over 28 million. In this video, we counted the number of spherical, frieze, and wallpaper symmetries. We saw that each symmetry has an orbifold, and that its characteristic must be positive for spherical symmetries, or zero for wallpaper. We then try every possible way of making an orbifold and finding its characteristic. For every good orbifold, I show that this symmetry actually exists by constructing an example of it. Now there's lots more in the book. The book talks about other kinds of symmetries and shows why this list of operations on orbifolds is complete. The argument I've used is based on the Euler map theorem, which I will prove in my next video. If you like this video, please click subscribe.